Jenny Jacobs here, and I am coming to you live from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and more specifically from inside my car. I spend a lot of time in my car every week, and so I thought I would do this blog from the driver's seat so you could join me for part of my daily commute. Part of my daily commute is also hopping on Highway 76, also known as the Schuylkill, and driving across town and into the suburbs where I teach. And so every day I get to hop on this highway and I get this great view of the city, which I'm gonna try to pop out and show you. Hopefully no one's getting sick. But yeah, so this is the view of the city that I have every day on my drive. Well, actually, I guess every other day. But it's really pretty, especially now that it's spring, and there's the Comcast building, the really tall one, and there's the pretty Amtrak building over there. And then in a moment, we're going to dive down, and you can sort of see there's the Schuylkill River. Hooray, Schuylkill! It's spelled really strangely, but it's fun. So this week I have been working on our website. I've been organizing fundraising efforts, researching sponsorship opportunities, stocking plane ticket prices. Yeah, I've been negotiating our contract with our performance venue, which I'm very excited about. I'm trying to create interesting ideas for challenges for the company coming up. I'm putting together an advertising package for Iris. Hello, there's a man crossing the street. And I thought he was gonna walk into me, but it's okay. I promise I'm driving very safely. The basic gist of it is when I'm not teaching, I am working on Iris and doing a lot to get ready for the Greek Theater project, which will be opening in June here in Philadelphia, and I'm very, very excited. February was a rough month. I think I definitely lost a lot of energy and I was feeling stressed about other things in my life, so it made it hard to work on Iris stuff and have the energy to do all that, but I'm feeling really rejuvenated. Things that are difficult or frustrating to work on, just time, finding the time to put everything together. It's tricky, but you know, we sort our way through it. So I hope that you guys will enjoy what I have in store for you today. I am going to introduce you to the four characters of the Greek Theater Project: Atalanta, Cassandra, Pandora, and Psyche. And I hope you enjoy meeting them.
Cassandra, blessed with the gift of prophecy and cursed so that no one would ever believe her predictions, she suffered through the Trojan War only to be taken as a war prize to the palace of Agamemnon, where she was murdered by his jealous wife. Her predictions are mentioned in many different stories throughout the Greek canon, including the heart-wrenching tale of her abduction from Athena's temple by the Greek hero Ajax. Pandora, the curious woman created by the gods, sent to humanity as a punishment for Prometheus's theft of fire. She married Epimetheus, the fire stealer's brother, and their wedding gift from the gods was a jar, commonly referred to as a box, which curiosity drove her to open, unleashing all the ills of the world. Psyche. Her name means soul, and she was the mortal who even love himself could not resist. When Eros, the invisible god of love, was so struck by her beauty, he accidentally pricked himself with his own arrow and fell deep in love with her. He brought her away to a palace where she could have anything she wanted, except to see who he was. Atalanta, the princess, huntress, and a warrior woman who, after pledging a vow of chastity, challenged any man who wanted to woo her to a foot race. The winner would get her hand in marriage. For the loser, death was his only prize. Atalanta was undefeated until the young Hippomenes distracted her with golden apples during the race and won her hand in marriage.
I hope that you are all having a great time and a good beginning to your spring. And stay tuned for more video blogs from the rest of the company coming up each week. Thanks for tuning in. Bye.